Jean-Christophe Granger, thank you so much for joining us on Showcase today. You are the author of some of the most popular thrillers ever written, both in your home country of France and so many other countries as well. How do these gripping suspense stories come to you?
It is a great mystery how ideas come to me. They come very quickly. Sometimes the inspiration comes to me in only a few hours. Once I have the idea of the story, I spend an entire year writing the best possible story I have in mind. I always say that there is a spark, a little flame of inspiration, and after that, I start working very hard and very patiently like a craftsman.
So why do you think people love to read thrillers so much?
I think what people find in thrillers is the same pleasure children find in scary tales of witches and wizards. Children like being told these kind of stories because they feel fear, but it is a false fear. They get scared, but they feel safe at the same time because they are next to you and know that they are only stories. It's a similar thing when adults read thrillers in their beds. They know that what's happening in the book isn't real. It's a little paradoxical because they read books about violence, death, torture and murder. These are all very scary themes, but they know that it's all fiction, and it would be pretty bizarre to forget the real horrors that exist in the world. We like to read all well-written horrors and well-detailed stories, so this is what I try to do. Personally, as a reader or as a member of the audience, I love stories that scare me.
And your works have been translated into more than 30 languages. You are one of the most widely read French authors in Turkey. Why do you think that is? I mean, your latest book, La Terre des Morts, The Land of the Dead, hasn't been translated into English yet, but it's already available in Turkish.
Honestly, I don't have an explanation. After France, it's Turkey where my books are read the most, and they've become so successful here. My editor was surprised to find this out as well. I don't think anyone can explain why, but I'm happy that I found a connection with the readers here. The turnout was incredible in the book signings. What surprised me the most was the amount of young people that showed up. This really touched me because unfortunately in France, many young people prefer to watch things on the internet instead of reading books. My books are not children's books, but I think it's the image of a strong man, someone from the dark side that appeals to the younger readers here. And I think there is a real maturity among Turkish readers.
Many of your readers found the Crimson Nurse film, starring Jean Reno and Vincent Cassel, to be very different from the book. It's also recently been adapted into a TV series. Do you imagine how the movie will be like when you're writing the books?
The number one rule when you write a novel is, you write a novel. You try to write the best novel you can possibly write. But if by chance the book gets adapted into a film, you have so many things to pray for because the medium of cinema is such a complicated environment, where there are so many people who give their opinions. The idea of a good adaptation of a book to the cinema is an illusion, a utopia. I can say this because I have often been involved in the process of adaptation. I always had very good relationship with the producers though, but this doesn't mean I can control everything. There are so many things imposed on you in the field of cinema. It's the opposite of writing. When you write a book, you decide on everything and anything you want to say. If all of a sudden you want an army of 5,000 people, it's possible because unlike cinema, there are no financial limitations or technical problems. The weather isn't an issue. You don't have to deal with the star who decides not to play at the last minute. When you see a movie on the screen, it's really the result of a big snowball. But I think I was lucky because my first film, The Crimson Rivers, is a movie that everyone loves. They still love it in France, where it's on TV. It's a great success, and it's a movie that has retained an emotional link with the public. People are happy to see Jean Reno, the mountains. I'm very happy to have started my film career with this movie. Today, TV series are more popular. I just wrote the script of a series with the same people who worked in the Crimson Rivers film, and has been a great success in France so far. Maybe it'll come to Turkey too.
And how about you? Who do you like to read? Who are some of your favorite authors?
It's not very easy because when you spend all day writing, you can't really read late in the day. I must confess that while I criticize the fact that people prefer watching TV over reading books, I do exactly the same. In addition to that, when you're reading a book, it reminds you that the fact that you are a writer yourself and you should go back to writing your own book. But I do read a lot. When I started writing crime novels, I devoured all the great masters of the genre, like the French author Sébastien Japrissot. His writing was very strong. And in the United States, I really love James Ellroy, whose books are very violent. But I must confess that most of the books that I read now are mainly informative, because when I'm writing a detective story, I have to read novels and documents to gather information on that particular subject.
And lastly, is there a new novel in the works? Are you writing anything new at the moment?
I am currently writing the series of four books inspired by the TV show version of The Crimson Rivers. I have already written the first one and is being published in France right now. I am now writing the second. I hope it goes well and I can complete the entire series soon.
Thank you so much for joining us on Showcase. It was a great chat and a great pleasure meeting you.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.